Welcome back, everybody, and thank you to all the new subscribers. Moving on, much appreciated. Hope you find it entertaining. This is a very small little project, but it's of interest because this is a Naim 72 control amplifier or preamp, and all the existing Naim boards have been discarded and been replaced with Ryan Audio. I think his name is Kit Ryan, and he has developed a whole series of So this gain board is completely redesigned, and you've got an op amp that does all the work, but you can step the gain 20 dB, 10 dB max. I don't know whether that's coming up, but it's a very nice device. You've got all the other boards, and you've got a volume control, remote volume control, which he runs off of a set of relays left and right, and this one board is left and right linked via a little ribbon cable here. Very nice. And here's the aerial, and a key fob remote to run it, which is very good. But my task for this gentleman is to replace these BNCs, on the ends here, for a quality pair of Phonos. And back in the day, BNCs were the preferred, and probably in and still are to a degree. You do get a far better contact point in the pin, on the positive pin. I mean, it's a tapered pin, so it actually slots in and a physical contact. These Phono types can be, if you don't buy good quality ones, these are very good quality ones, Cardis Audio. I mean, they're not cheap, but they're very good quality, and I'm going to replace those with these. And because these are universal, everybody uses these now. Very few people use these BNC locking. They're a locking device. But anyway, that's what I'm going to do. I'm just going to remove these and replace them with these. So I'm going to switch the iron on, and I'll be back shortly. So it's just a simple matter of desoldering these wires. We will reuse this cable. There's absolutely nothing wrong with this cabling whatsoever. So apply a bit of heat and just gently remove the wires. If they don't come off first time, you sometimes have to just wet the joint. So a little bit of solder, just wet the joint, and that heat will then transfer. Sorry for the wobble. And that will just come away like that. Just like that, nice and gently. Ever so easy, nothing difficult about that. So now we have to undo these, and I think that's a 13mm spanner. I've got my 13mm spanner to hand. Oh, apparently not. Well, I'll just go and get a spanner, I'll be back. So 13mm spanner, had it right beside me. Fits perfectly Blimey. I think these were done up. They were done up finger tight. So it's just a matter of whipping them out. Sometimes they're very tight in these holes. And I have seen these glued in position. But there you go. Didn't see that, so I'm going to do it again. There we go. So just gently pull them out, put them to one side, get the scissors out. Warning, cancer and reproductive harm. What on earth are these made out of? I'd hate to think. So channel one is normally the right hand channel, so I'm going to put the red one, red for right. Now, I may well have to drill these holes. Because this, yes, it won't quite go in because there's a step. I think I see that there's a step for that, or you can file it, but I'm just going to just whip that out with a drill. I'll be back in a second. So all I've done is rounded out that hole with a drill, just like that, nothing to it. Blow the debris away, and it's a matter of just installing these lovely phonos. So that fits in there perfectly now. You've got a couple of insulating washers, and one of them has a step, and the step goes in the hole. So we put the step on there. That goes in the hole, he says. Yes, goes like that. I'm just looking at the quality of the finish, fit and finish of these. They're very, very good. So that goes in there. The other washer goes on the back. You have an earth tab which we will solder to. The earth tab goes on next, and I'll just bend that up slightly. Then you have a nice big nut that goes on the back of that, so you just spin it up. Like that. Hit your spanner. Do it up. So I'm going to repeat that process for the next one. Look for me stepped. There's me step. So that goes in first, like that. Then we have the second insulating washer, and we have the earth tab. You've probably seen this a million times on YouTube. So many people have done it over the years, but probably not on a Naim 72. One of the problems can be you can't get enough torque. Now normally on a lot of these phonos you will have a hex on this side, so you can put a spanner on this side as well as on the inside, but there's no such facility on this, so you have to resort to a bit of butchery with a pair of pliers, which is, I mean, how tight do you need them? That's the point, isn't it? And we'll just tease those tabs out. Watch your felt, that's no good at all, because the wire, yes it will. The wire will come through just to be at an angle like that. I'm going to do the same. Yeah, that'll be fine. So what I'm going to do now is just tin or wet the tabs on here. And if you've done this a few times, you know good quality materials, because the flux just adheres straight away. Good jollop on there like that. Thus, I'm going to do the bottom one first. So what we're going to do is reattach this braided, which is the earth, and it has to go, a little bit of jiggery pokery here, it has to go that way around. So there's your signal and there's your earth. What I'm going to do, because that is proving difficult, is just ease these along a bit. What's that? That's fine. Just ease that along so that one does that. That one does that. In actual fact, I don't like that at all. So what I'm going to do, warts and all as they say, is spin that earth tab round so that it's at the bottom as it was previously. Why didn't I do that in the first place? Pratt. Sorry, I can't. I'm getting in your way, but not the way around it. Sorry. Let me just get this tab around the right way. We want him out the bottom. Not being very helpful, this one. There we go. So the earth tab's at the bottom. Lovely. I'll put a little bit more solder on the bottom one. Add it a bit more. I'm working around this camera again, which is a pain, but there we go. So we just reattach that one on there. We can't see this. I can't get in there and do this. Watch you. So it will be what it is. Give it a tug, perfect. We're going to do this one. Actually, in fact, we're going to do the top one first here. Apply the heat. See it run. That fits in there nicely. I'll double check all this afterwards. We're just looking to make sure this is a nice wet joint, and they are. Bottom one's lovely as well. So that's the process of how to fit phono sockets. A bit of dust here, let's get me brush. For those that may or may not know, just to explain what I've done here, the owner wishes to use some phono inputs. Now, the phono inputs are for a record deck, but in actual fact, I think what he's done, he can use a CD player because he's put these link boards, in effect, replace what would be the phono boards. These are, I think, time alignment boards go here, and this is this one here is a D-thump, but this Ryan audio setup, it looks very good quality, everything fits perfect, there's good results. I know somebody that had some of these and rated them very highly. You have on each of these boards, which is interesting, you have regulators here. I'm going to get me loop out and find out what they are. Tell you what they are. As a regulator, probably a 317. If I can find the loop was here yesterday. Where's my loop? I was only looking at it yesterday. It was here. Hopefully we're not going to run out of time. I'll be back just in a second. $14,203. But yes, it's quality product, quality materials. It looks like it's beautifully built, wonderfully built. So I am going to, the owner said I could have a listen to it. I am going to have a listen to it. I've done the task that he asked me to do. I'm just going to check continuity to make sure that what I've done is going to work. So we get our meter. So we go from the pin to pin. Correct. We go from pin to pin. Correct. And we're going to go from earth, ground, I'm going to go to ground. Perfect. Do this one. Recess. Come on. Actually, it has to go there, does it? It's actually that one there. Yeah, there. So, yeah, perfect. So I know now. I've checked that, and now I know it will work. That's good. So, this little exercise completed. I might come back. I'll go away and have a quick listen to this, and I'll stick a bit on the end of this video, just to highlight my thoughts. Not that it makes any difference whatsoever, because people do their own thing. Just a little note: if you've got these and you intend to take them somewhere, move them. Move this preamp. These jumper boards, when I received this device through the post, these jumper boards were just flapping about inside the case, whereby they've come off their pins, because it's no hardship for it to fall off, really. This board should be what you call full height. So the board should be as high as this one, so that when you slide the case in, there's no way that this board can actually jump out. So what I have done in the past, not for Ryan product, but for other stuff that people, DIY stuff, I put a little tiny bit of blue tack just on the bottom there like that. Then that adheres to the motherboard like that. And that, I'm not going to say it's going to completely stop it, but that's going to help it stay in place whilst it's in transit. So it's just a little bead of tacky, blue tack, or, you know, sticky. That goes on there, and that pinches up against the motherboard, and that will, you've got to really pull that. It's not going to harm anything. If you don't like it, you can take it off once you get it home. But there's a way of keeping these boards in situ. I think they're Ryan board. I can't honestly say if they are Ryan boards or not. I think they might be. I don't know. But if you have got short boards, a bit of blue tack, and that will stop them jumping out if this is in transit. I mean, most of the time, these things don't move from a shelf. But if you're having it serviced, I'd hate for this to rattle around and actually hit some of these devices, some of these capacitors. Little polystyrene capacitors here can be delicate. But there you go. Just a little snippet. So the next little task the owner has asked me to undertake is to put some new rubber feet on. You can see it. I don't know whether it adversely affects the sound quality, but these are perished. These are old. And these are difficulty with these. So how do you get the screw out? Well, you just force it out like that. You just push the rubber past the screw head. Thus. Like that. Just like that. And how do I get the new ones on? Well, for that you need a little device. And it's a vice. A device is a vice. And you just force that, this is a new one, force that in there, and you get a big screwdriver and just push them in. So there's number one. It might be to three. No, I'm a foot short. There we go. There you go. So now we can go back to the preamp. And these just screw in. They don't have to be graunched up, nipped up by finger tight like that. And there's also little M5 device with its M5 cap head that goes through to the chassis to bond the chassis to the sleeve. That's a throwback from the days when this would have been apparent before and you had mains on it. In fact, you've only got 12 volts or 24 volts. So that's nice new rubber feet, nice new Phono sockets on the back, nothing's rattling inside. Nice, these are nice. One of the better products in my view that they did, the fact that you could upgrade it. Not that they had any intention for the owner to do so, but for the DIYer, these are very, very good value for money and you can make them sound quite superb. So I will pack up all this detritus that was the leftovers and ship this back with the unit to the customer. Do you remember when we fell in love? We were young again in a Do you remember how it all began? It just seemed like heaven, so I Yeah, very nice. Works a treat. Sounds okay to me. Job done. Thanks for watching. Bye.